A sub-3-hour marathon marks you as an above-average runner. Of course, you are within an hour from the lead field, but hey, only 4% of male and 1% of female last year ran under 3 hours. So, running a marathon is hard. Doing it in less than 3 hours is really hard. But can you do it without being a talent? Yes, and if I made it, you can make it. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get there, how I made it, and how you can make it as well. With some dedication, a proper routine, and a lot of pasta. Let's go! Hi, I'm Claudio Cavacini, an engineer, a sub-3-hour marathoner, and a coach. And in this channel, we talk about running. I help you in enjoying the journey in becoming a better, stronger, and smarter runner. And yes, the journey is always better than the destination. Let's go! I started running because I was a bit overweight. I always loved sport, but life took me into a place where for years I haven't practiced any. When I started, I didn't really know that you could have raced almost every week, that you could have joined a team, that you could have met a lot of friends and for me, the love of my life, that you could have traveled around the world and joined the most spectacular marathon out there, with thousands of runners like you. So this is exactly what's going to happen to you if you just started. But I digress. When I say to people that I run a sub-3-hour marathon, they think I am a super talent. They think it's a crazy speed, something that they cannot achieve. But is it really true? The short answer is no. And if you are willing to put a lot of dedication and time, you are going to make it. The long answer is a bit more complex. Training for a marathon is a really long process. It can last 15 to 20 weeks where you have to put a very solid training. And of course, everything can happen. That is why I always say that if you get to the starting line of a marathon in a healthy condition, that's already a victory. Most people will simply abandon the training because it's too much, because they get hurt, or simply for a mental reason because they cannot make it anymore. So this is valid in life in general. When you want to achieve something, you need to make it as a priority. I have many friends that tell me, oh, I cannot run, I don't have time. My answer to that is no, you have time. It's simply that running a marathon for you is not a priority. And it's fine, and it's fair enough. I have a corporate job, a 10-month-old son, and pre-COVID I used to travel 1 or 2 days per week sleeping in a hotel room. So if I have time, you have time. But for me, running a sub-3-hour marathon was an important goal, and for this reason, I set up alarm clock at 5:30 or at 6 o'clock. Or I said no to lunch with colleagues and friends just to do my training and then have a sandwich in front of my computer. This leads us to the first tips that I have for you. Commit to it. You'll have to know you have to put from 6 to 8, 9 hours per week of training. And this is excluding the time for getting there, the shower, and so on. Of course, this can vary and depend the case and case, and not every week must be exactly the same of the prior, but the secret is consistency. So a bad week means nothing. A bad day means nothing. But if you start collecting many weeks of no training, many bad days, then that's impacting. The second tip I want to give you is food. Even here, there are many different opinions and nutrition is very personal and depends on your health history. But let me say that during the marathon journey, you'll see your body changing. And that's because the plenty of easy run that you will do, so your body will learn burning fat instead of carbs. This doesn't mean you can eat everything you want, but you'll have to support the miles that you're putting in. In my case, I was totaling a 100K week, and I was eating at lunch and dinner 150 grams of pasta and 150 grams of protein meal. And of course, I had 2 snacks during the day, which was more or less 1/2 kilo of fresh fruits. And obviously, I used to start my morning with a big breakfast. And by the way, my body weight is 66 kilos. The third tip I have for you is get out with friends. I know that it's not always easy, especially in big city, to meet up with friends and go for runs, but that's very important. It's a mental thing, and a marathon is a lot of mental. So if you get done your training, especially your easy run with friends, that will make things easier for you. Every athlete is different, so for example, for me, I used to like to do my long runs by myself because I used to set up my goal pace. And you know, if you are alone, you can make sure that you can keep the pace. When you are out with friends, there's always a little bit of competition, and so you end up finishing your training with much faster a lot of time, which can be good, but sometimes it's not good. The fourth tip is have a plan. This means to get a coach, get a book, get a training plan online, whatever, but get something to work on. I've intentionally set this as a fourth rule, not because it's not important, but because there are really plenty of options. You cannot simply randomly training and expect to have a good marathon, because you'll have to build your mileage, you'll have to build your endurance, your speed, your threshold run. So it's very important to follow some rules. If you want to hear more about this, let me know in the comments and I can share some more details of my training plan from Chicago and the Berlin Marathon. But in few words, my week was 100K weeks. Monday was rest. Then I had on Sunday the long run, Tuesday a speed session, and on Friday a marathon pace or a threshold pace. The rest of the week was easy run just to get the 100K done. I know it's very generic, but it's all it takes. Maybe your training pace will not be sub 3 hour marathon pace, the first marathon, but you'll get there. Maybe the second, maybe the third, but you'll get there. I hope that by now you have the self-confidence that you can make it. We are all human, and whatever your end goal is far away from your potential. You get to know this. So think big, think in the long term. Yes, it's very good to have a slower goal at the beginning, but you need to look a little bit far away. I'm planning to get deeper into some training sessions, so stay tuned. A good run. Ciao, ciao.